Hey guys, just got back from a long practice session for the Polecat ALES electric contest coming up next week. And I wanted to give you an update on what's going on with the F3X building clinic, which is now finally in production. Now, it took a couple of extra weeks to get my nice Explorer into the shop here so we can actually start production here. So we're running definitely a couple of weeks behind here. These planes are really hard to get right now. And I wanted a certain wing setup and a certain color combination along with the new X3 fuse design with the new crosstails. So the plane, thanks to Soaring USA and MKS Servos USA, all the servos and parts are now here in the shop and we started production, and I hope to be wrapped up with this film about the first week of July, if not earlier. Since I'm running a little bit late with this production, I'm extending the free video offer for a few more weeks for those who pre-order the F3X building clinic. Your pre-order really helps keep things going and helps finance this production while we're making it. You get your choice of a free DVD or digital download to go along with your F3X purchase, kind of like a two-for-one deal. Now, instructions on how to get the free item are on the F3X order pages, super easy. Now, the video sets and the new DLG clinic are not included with this offer. Now let's take a quick look at the Explorer and some of the new gear I'm going to be putting in it. Now, like all my videos, we're going to cover the full assembly of this airplane in minute detail, from taking it out of the box to putting it on a mono F5J winch in a week or so. We're going to cover all those assembly details, of course, but we're also going to talk about some of the new battery technology, servo technology, because that's changing really fast. I'm going to show you how to make a nice lightweight wiring harness for this airplane. I'm going to work a lot on the servo geometries and getting those set up correctly so you have maximum resolution from the servos that you select. We're going to set this up with a magnetic Zepsus switch system on it, which is really cool. Just do all those little hundreds of details so this airplane is 95% perfect before it leaves the shop. And once we put it on the winch and high start for our test flights, it's going to be pretty much there. And the only thing that's going to be left is some fine tuning. So this is the new X3 fuselage configuration with a new modular tail that they've come up with. So they've ditched the full flying stab and gone to a flapped horizontal stab. This kind of reminds me of the old school slope razors we used to do back in the 90s and early 2000s. It's pretty much an old school sort of shape in the fuse. And I think it's pretty cool. It's simple, it's light, it's strong. So the modular tail is kind of neat. So what they've done is they've increased the actual flap area on the rudder here. And then it's got two pegs that plug into the stab here and capture it into the fuselage. You can see the pegs here and here. And once you push it down, there's a little lock mechanism here which locks it in place. And you hook up the push rods, which are just real simple L-bends, which are captured into the surfaces here. So it's very light, it's very strong, it's efficient. So the reason for the flapped elevator is you get improved pitch response, especially high-speed pitch response during the zoom and also during landing here. So at low speeds, you've got enough oomph on the elevator here to really push that airplane over, where with a full flying stab, there's a little bit of that kind of lag where the stab kind of stalls and then it pushes the plane down. And also in the zoom bucket here, you can really get a lot of pressure and make that airplane really pop fast off the tow line and get a better zoom here. So that's an improvement. I've flown a couple of different ones with the new three tail on it, and I really like the elevator feel, kind of like a big hand launch. Very precise, and when you push that plane over, it goes over. There's no lag, no delay. So big improvement on the X3 as far as the aerodynamics and the tail feel. Now we're going to be talking about switches, both mechanical and some of the new magnetic ones. These are the ones from Zepsus, which I really like. And this is just a plain switch, and then they've got these new regulating switches which can regulate power and also act as a magnetic switch. Very cool stuff. Now the Explorers are traditionally set up with DB9s, but we're going to ditch these. These are kind of old school. We're going to go with 6-pin multiplexes for the wings and these little adapter plates which plug into the space where the DB9s went. Now to mount the servos and the wings, we're going to be using the new bearing style frames here, which add extra support to the bearing area and the output shaft of the servo. These are from Servo Ramen, and we've got these from Soaring USA. We're going to be using these for the 6100 HVs and the ailerons, and for the 6625, the new brushless flap servos. For receiver, I'm using the AR9310 DMSX, of course, with my 9503 transmitter. These have the extended carbon antennas here. We're definitely going to be putting those to use, as this is an all-carbon fuse. In this video, we're going to talk a lot about batteries, and we're going to be using some new technology. These are the new Panasonic. These are 3,100 milliamp cells in the 18650 size, These are pretty awesome, 3.7 volts, so same as a LiPo. So we're probably going to run these 2S in the fuse here, and we'll compare these to, say, nickel metal hydride 5-cell pack. Now, since this plane is only getting the best servos, I'm using the MKS for all of the servos on this airplane. And this is my elevator servo, kind of an unusual choice here. This is the HV9767. It's got 130 ounces of torque, very fast, very strong servo. Why do I pick something so big for the elevator? Well, resolution, very low dead band, and for the zoom on launch, you want an air servo that's super strong and is going to put the elevator where you want it really fast and really powerfully. This thing's a tractor. It's been tested for thousands of hours, apparently. And this is the servo that a lot of the F3B and F5J pilots are using currently for their elevator. Now for the ailerons, we're going to use the light and small but powerful. This is the new HV6100s here. They'll run up to 8.4 volts, which is really nice. One of the advantages of HVs is you can run smaller servos. So we can run these in the ailerons and have plenty of torque. I think it's close to 60 ounces of torque at 8.4 volts. So very fast response. Again, very low dead band and very powerful for ailerons, and it saves a lot of weight on the tips. And for the flaps, we're using something pretty exciting. These are the new MKS6625. This is a brushless motor servo. This is the first brushless servo I've put on a plane. Very, very strong, tons of torque. In fact, I got a warning that you can tear the horns out of the flaps if you're not careful. So you got to make sure your linkages are set up right for these. They have so much torque. Absolutely rock solid, no play at all. And these are going to be an excellent choice for the flaps. You put the flaps down at any speed. Good camber settings and good for landing. This thing is going to outlast probably three airplanes. And for rudder, we're going to use the HV6100 again. Saves weight. It's got plenty of torque at 8.4 volts and it'll save a little bit of room up front in the fuse. And we're going to build our own harness. I found some really nice three-strand lightweight wire here. It's a lot lighter than regular servo wire. It's got a very high wire count in here and should save us some weight off our harness.